chest. Something to roll back, they should have let rest. So this is a call. Open your eyes, you think the fate in your dream. You've been beating your lies, and it goes like 3, 2, 1.
So will you let me destroy you? fucking noise!
Let's be nothing. Can't be nothing. Feel the same. Why we're nothing left.
It is hot as fuck in here, man. Make some noise for yourselves for going so hard right now. Make some noise. Welcome to the We're All in Danger Tour. This is the last stop of our first headlining tour. We're happy to spend it right here in Ohio. But check it out. If you've never heard of Dangerkids or never seen us live before, I want to dedicate this next song to you guys out there, okay? Listen to these words very closely. This song is called Paper Thin.
Deeper, we shock, it's a little bit deeper inside.
guys so much. Yo, Lakewood, man, are you guys okay? Because we're dying up here. You guys good for real? I would enjoy a magical hole in the ceiling with massive airflow right now. Not a tornado, though. Just somewhere halfway there. Meet me halfway. So, we're a band called Dangerkids. We're from Ohio. We're from Dayton, Ohio. And, dude, I have to ask, how many of you guys have seen us before? Can I see hands? Dude, fuck yeah, man. Oh, my God. Thank you guys so much for coming back. I hope we are getting better and not worse. And I can take it. Debatable. My best years are behind me, I know. On this stage, dude, anyone will age faster up here. I'm serious. I'm like 48 now. But it means a lot, man, it does. We've never headlined a tour ever in our lives. And a lot of people told us that we shouldn't or we couldn't. And guess what, man, this is the last day. Fucking success, dude. Best thing we ever did. It was the best thing we ever did for a lot of reasons. Like, one, we get to reconnect with people that we consider family. Friends, family. I know that a lot of the bands have actual family here. And that we noticed that. That's all I'm saying. We noticed that, and it means a lot. And we usually don't have the time to say that or talk. It's usually like, play the most badass 20 minutes you can and fuck off. You know what I mean? Which is fine. I know I have band dudes out there that know what I'm talking about. Band guys, yeah? 20 fucking, that's all you need, dude. You're just like, give me 20 minutes. Dude, it gets way harder when they're like, oh, you got an hour. And you're like, I ain't in that kind of shape, dude, at all. I'll get up there and fake it, but that's why I jump around a lot. I'm like, you guys are like, he's killing it. No, I'm not. I'm just like, sing it. Yeah, cool.
I mean, if you guys want to see how hot I am up here, just see if you can see this.
Are you steaming? Oh! No warning at all.
It's bad.
That's revenge for earlier. Never mind. Different story. Story for a different time. Whoa! Headshot. Kinda. No scope. 360. Never mind. We're internet weirdos. I just want to say this. It means the world. I can't believe we never thought we would headline. We joked about it. Like, no joke. And the joke name for the tour was the We're All in Danger Tour. And we'd be like, what's the We're All in Danger Tour going to look like, dude? Seriously, and we had a lot of ideas. Andy had a dream lineup that was like hilarious. I don't remember.
Alien Ant Farm, SR-71, Fountains of Wayne.
Fountains of Wayne, that's the one I can never think of. The original Stacey's Mom band. Yeah. We were just like, in an awesome world, wouldn't it be so cool to like side stage just watch Stacey's Mom every
Bowling night? Pursuit played it every day on Warped Tour, and everyone just like was like, oh, that's their song. It's like, no, it's Fountains of Wayne. I don't know, it's weird.
We got into a big debate about it, but Andy was right after all. So, Fountains of Wayne. We're here spreading the word. They originally wrote Stacey's Mom. It's really important that you guys know that. You end up with a lot of downtime on the road. Any of my band dudes, like, touring at all yet? You guys there yet? Yeah. A lot of downtime. Your standard for comedy, like, kind of drops. All of a sudden, it's, like, butt jokes and stuff you never think's funny. You're just like, butts. But this is the last date of that, man. Everybody's gonna go home. We've been on the road with an awesome band called Abbey and Row, which played right before us. What'd you guys think of them? Woo, I thought that was going all the way. There's like beach ball madness happening in the background. No warning. I'll take the blame for that. They say Abbey and Row on them, so if you guys need to sue somebody, just, they actually say Dangerkids, but yeah, whatever. They opened the show with my old band's song. What? You guys know Let's Get It? All right. I'm just gonna keep this rolling then. This goes out to all the Let's Get It fans still in the house. Lakewood, are you still with us? Come on, make some noise. Thank you so much for making tonight possible, man. It means the world. This song is about getting knocked down. Getting told to stay down and getting the fuck back up anyways, all right? This song is called Hostage, and it's the biggest fucking jump song of them all. I want to see you will bob your feet when this kicks in. 3, 2, 1! Yeah. Woo. Yeah!
that danger is real.
Feel it all the time.
So where did the name to remind me why everything I gave up where I'm left behind just to be where I am tonight, yeah. So you can't touch me, I can't be touched. You can't hold me, you waste too much. You can't buy me a half the price.
You have no backup, but you have no crush.
One last attempt, all out attack. And if you push me, I'll push you back. So I fall, you go down with me. Make sure you remember.
You have what it takes. The lows and the fun. You live me, it's just fun. It comes with the pride. If you've got nothing at all,
you got nothing to lose.
Fucking good. I was supposed to give him my rap verse. Instead, I gave him a fucking big screaming part, and he just did it anyways, man. That's fucking awesome. Dude. I thought we had an agreement. You were supposed to make me look good, but whatever. Like, mess up a little bit. You know, fudge the words, whatever. No, I love you, man. Great job. I almost left you out, and I was like, shit! I, like, saw you. Totally forgot. I'm up here, like, traveling through space and time in this heat and just, like, getting older by the second. all I want to say is this next song, if you've seen us live, there's probably, like, a 50% chance that we played it. And we love this song for a lot of reasons, and I never get to talk, like I said. And I would love to tell you guys about this song really quick, if that's cool. Basically, it just goes like this. The next track is important to us, actually, for a lot of reasons, but one of the biggest reasons is it's the first song we ever wrote, and it came about in a very organic and, like, sort of depressing way. All it really was, like, you guys know I was in a band before this band. It was called Let's Get It. I loved that band, and I identified with it so much. I'd never been signed to a label. I had never toured. I remember seeing California for the first time. I remember flying on a plane for the first time. All these things that you never think of when you're just a kid sitting in a room, like, wondering if you'll ever be great. And I don't know if my music guys know what I'm talking about, but it was a magical time. And you know what, man? some really great things, not all, but some of them come to an end. And this thing did, and honestly, I was so ready, but I wasn't ready for all the stuff that came after that you don't think about, like all the free time that you don't want. You know, it's like the thing that used to take up your day. I don't know if you guys have something out there that you identify with, or a person, or a thing, or like, you know what I mean? I would have told you, I'm Tyler, I play music, this is my band, this is like who I am, like, truly. And to have that taken away one day and become like Tyler who like eats and sleeps and stuff, you know what I mean? That's how it is though, man. I sat there and I was like, hey, I'm Tyler, I exist, that's it. Like, I don't have, that passion was taken away, you know? And like, I remember just lying awake at night wondering like who I was without this thing. And I remember sitting on Facebook and seeing all my friends, all these people doing what made them happy. And I was like, you have to ask yourself that really hard question, like, who am I? Like, what do I do with my limited time here, right? Because I thought it was music. And the funny thing is, I wrote what became this next song. And out of that song came this band that was never supposed to play shows, by the way, ever. I shit you not, our band goal was we decided we were gonna be the most badass band that never played shows. We were gonna do 4 songs and hopefully get enough iTunes money to shoot a music video one day. And I'm not talking a big, I'm talking just something, right? And we never thought past that. That's why I'm rapping right now, right? We didn't think this through all the way. Like, I was just like, that's pretty weird. Nobody will expect that out of me. Andy's never sang in a band in his life. Jake is not a bass player. This is his first time playing bass. Katie doesn't do double kick. Do you see where I'm getting with this? Like, I picked a bunch of my friends and we got together and all of a sudden we were just having fun again. And I forgot, like, the last time I made a song that was fucking so fun that when we listened to it, we just busted up laughing. Like, we were like, oh my God, I'm rapping, this is hilarious, dude. No one's ever gonna hear this. Who cares, you know? And like, we didn't even, in the beginning, I don't know if you guys remember this far back, but we didn't have like promo photos, we didn't have anything. There were just dark shadows in front of our faces because we were just gonna be these weirdos in the internet, I guess. And like, just the guy that, you know, your worst nightmare, the guy that's just outside of your field of vision behind you, that was us. And on some level, I would like to think that we're still those kids in that one-bedroom apartment just fucking around. But you know what? It's really awesome because that song happened, and then this band happened, and then an album, right? And then we did play shows because we were like, I don't know, it's we played so many shows where no one is there. Do my band dudes know what I'm talking about right now? I know. Okay. It's almost like a rite of passage, man, and you play for the other bands and the sound guy and the parents, and like, it's important though, it is, and it shapes you, it reminds you you're not that fucking cool, like you need to chill the fuck out, take off your sunglasses sometimes, like, and man, this first album changed my life and changed all of our lives, and it's taken us around the world, and this is the last stop of our first headlining tour. This is also the end of our first album cycle, which is like crazy because how many of us had never left the country? All of us, right? We've been to Australia, we've been to Japan, we've gone through Europe, we've done Warped Tour. What the fuck is life? You know what I mean? That's all we're saying the whole time. We're like, we don't deserve any of this, but yeah, we'll take it. We'll just do our fucking best, you know? And I guess I don't feel like I deserve to be up here now because I don't know, man. All I want to say is this song is the beginning of this band, and it's the end of this album to me. Although we have a few songs left after this, I just want to dedicate it to anyone out there who's on that grind and let you know that it's about the lowest, shittiest point in my life and how music was able to lift me up out of that. And maybe it can do the same for you guys. The song is called Light Escapes. Thank you. Thank you for letting me explain that tonight, man.
One less left.
Deep in his chest, the hope is gone of him getting out, removed from
yeah.
hopeless song.
He turned his head months at a time, but he couldn't lie. He couldn't time, and he couldn't rhyme. He trusted himself to save his life.
He put his favorite records on
in a party in Lincoln Park. Close his eyes, he'd sing along.
He'd never make it on his own.
It's not the time, and it's not the place to have to eat your words. It's not the fun, it's not the thing.
It's what you do right after words.
Stand at these words, I hope you rise. Sing it deep, choose a song. Grab the mic, don't shock them all. Just any means of wild eyes.
Wild fire.
Yourself, you will succeed. And if you take anything away from our show tonight, always know what you stand for. Thank you, guys.
And make some noise for drama on bass. Did he figure that out in like 15 seconds? You're like, switch, leave these notes. Good luck.
Like, all day, we're like, what can we do to prank?
That was well
we're
done.
Like, what can we do to prank Avi on Rhodes last day tour? Do a little innocent tour prank. Apparently you two, scheming motherfuckers, had it figured out all day, so.
It's like the meanest thing we could think of. I was like, I suck at bass, put me in your band.
I knew it, I knew you were sucking on purpose. Somewhere in there, there's talent. I'm still digging for it, I'm just kidding. We sabotaged their set.
give yourselves a round of applause, please, because I feel bad, because I feel like it's so fucking hot up here. I feel like I'm giving it like 80% and y'all are still going like super hard. These risers right here are like a nice little knee-high crutch that I can just kind of like take a breath on and try to look cool while doing it, but I'm really just like dying, like and again, this is like a really bittersweet thing. It's the last day of this tour. And this has been one of the most fun tours we've ever done. If nothing else, just because of Avi on Road, they're such genuine, awesome people. And we made some really, really great friends this tour, and that doesn't happen very often. Thank you guys again for coming out to the last night of the Raw in Danger tour. Thank you so much. Tyler's struggling with a broken microphone over here. You all good?
I'm good. Hey!
There it is.
Woo! Sorry, guys, my mom called. I'm just kidding. I was trying to think of the lamest excuse.
No, my mic is, it's actually funny, not that you guys care, but underneath of this, it is literally snapped in half. So, like, changing batteries, I'm like, this might be it. This might be the last time I use it. So, if I shake it too hard, it turns off. It's a problem when you jump around for a job. But, we normally have one song left. If it's okay, I'd love to play two more, just it being the last day. Is that cool? Cool. Well, shit, is that cool? Okay, just making sure. Like, you know what I'm talking about, right? Okay. This next song is normally the last song. We've closed with it almost every time, but there's a really special reason for why that is. And I just wanted to tell you guys that this song was written to be, what's happening back there? I'm not allowed to know, okay. Oh, nice. Have you guys ever seen Katie get a drumstick stuck in her hair? It's my all-time favorite. It happens, just you have to be watch very close. She like drums so hard, and then she just leaves it and grabs another one. It's great, it's like the Flintstones or something. All I wanna say about this next song is that we wrote it to be like our victory lap, you know what I mean? Which is like really stupid when you haven't achieved shit, but we were sitting there and we were like, let's write a song that's like, fuck yeah, we're playing music, this is all we ever wanted, and it became this next song, which is called Waking Up. And I think it requires you to be like 50% stupid and maybe like 50% like believing in yourself and stuff. But like, I'd love for you guys to take this lap with us right here and pretend, I know it's not the last song, but let's treat it like it is, man. Let's do something crazy. I wanna see it. Aww. All right, it goes like this.
Dropping me and bringing out Dangerkids tonight.
one of you guys leaves, all right? Thank you so much.
He's better!
You thought I was on a mission to look cool. I was just getting the beach ball down. So thank you guys for helping me with that. I didn't want the venue to get mad at me. We're good, right? Yeah.
Thank you guys for not dropping our rapper.
Yeah, because then you would just be a rapperless band. There'd be a lot of dead spots in the songs. Used to be something here.
Be a dead spot right there, too.
Yeah.
That would have been a great tour prank if you guys all just dropped it.
Yeah, don't do that ever. It's... Leave it to Katie, jeez. So, I do this thing on tours, and I have never done it on this tour. I'm going to do it tonight. It's a thing I call Katie's Corner, where I interview Katie, and I just... It's very quick, so you have to pay attention. Hi, Katie. Welcome to Katie's Corner. How you doing?
I'm doing all right.
What is your favorite thing about being a terrible drummer? That's a good answer. Thank you guys so much. This has been Katie's Corner. I was just joking. You guys know Katie's fucking awesome, right? Yeah. Last show, last night, everyone was chanting Katie, and I'm just like, man, no love for the rest of us, right? But I think I can do it again. Katie, 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 Katie. All right. Dude, I love you guys. So we have one song left, and this doesn't exactly qualify, but it's my birthday in 3 days, so if anyone wants to buy me a beer or something, like, I'm open to that. I've actually had a horrible diet today, so, right? Yeah, you were there. Just energy drinks and alcohol and some grilled cheese. Is it? Hang on.
Oh, shit! So, Jordan.
What did Evan say before? He was like, sports ball. Isn't that what he said or something up here? He was like, it's sports ball, guys. He said something like that. It's a sports game. Fuck yeah.
So I'm a Sharks fan, and Jordan is a Pittsburgh fan, and we're friends, but we made agreement that, well, it's more on him side. He's gonna talk a lot of shit to me over the next like week or so. But if we do win, I'm gonna rub it in so hard.
Ooh. So check it. Oh my god.
Oh.
Is this? Oh my god.
Chug it, chug it, chug it, chug it.
All right. I'm gonna drink this, and Evan's gonna break it over his head, all right?
How do you spin this thing around your neck? Is it hard? Drink that shit, come on.
Damn. Guys, this is why the last day of tour is special, because there's basically no rules, and it's actually really sad, because after this show, after this last song, we're gonna have to say goodbye to these guys, but I have to shout them out. Abby and Roe, is anyone here going to Warped Tour this year? They will see you there, all right? And their album is up for pre-order right now. You guys got all this dope shit going on. I love you, by the way, Moscato. Moscato's, actually, that's like champagne Moscato, but... down with it. Really? Hey, cheers. Thank you. Are you serious?
So we've had this running
You should stick around real quick. There's a shirt.
Can you guys just hang out here?
Yeah. Why don't you guys just do this whole song with us?
Let's
you know
come on,
words.
Josh.
Yeah.
Evan.
All right.
We've had this running joke on this tour. It actually started the first night of this tour in Dayton. We don't normally play this song. It's a little bit slower. It's like a slow jam. It's like a little feely. And Tyler was like, you know, you can't really headbang to the song, but you can headbang with your heart. And I said, you can heart bang.
Which has become, heart bang has become Andy's 80s cover band, right?
Yeah, all
dopest name ever for an 80s metal.
We exclusively play Enter Sandman 12 times in a row, or until everyone leaves, whichever comes first. Usually everyone leaves after like round two, but.
So check it out. You can't headbang, but you can headbang with your heart to this last song. This song I want to dedicate to Abby and Roe for being literally like brothers to us and something that you don't ever find when you're on the road. It's usually an awesome half hour to an hour a night and a bunch of like wishing you were home and being with friends and family and just trying to do your best to stay in touch and keep it all together. It's not an easy life that we've chosen. But you guys get to see the best half hour and the best hour of it. And honestly, we do it for moments like this and moments like this and meeting friends. And you know what I mean? It's the nights you won't remember with the people you'll never forget kind of thing. So this last song, I'd love it if you guys would just fucking forget about all the bullshit for a little while and rock out to one more song with us. It goes like this. It's called Unmade. This is for all the chips. I learned this trick from Evan.
Stand in the thought of my own life. Phone in my hand, it's midnight. All this talk has never got the sound right.
Thank you guys so fucking much.
Thank you, Cleveland!
You guys are like family to us. Thank you so much for spending the last show of our first headliner together as family, man. We will see you next time. We've been Danger Kids. Have a good night.